So, sampadane karke chaturthi vibhakti vaktavya upadhyaya gam dadati manokaya viksham dadati devadataya rochate. See how varied it is. You have the ruch, spriha, and then this is the vartika. Oh, there is one thing I must point out. You know the word vartika. The vartika is ukta nukta durukta chintakatvam vartikatvam. What is upsankhyana? See, we generally recognize the vartika with the use of the word kartavyam, vaktavyam, na vaktavyam, etc., etc. Generally, not always. But there are commentators, all commentators do. So like Katyayana, Patanjali, everyone uses, but not just vaktavyam. They also use upasankhyana. So what is the difference between upasankhyana? People say that this is an upasankhyana vartika. So what is the difference between upasankhyana and a vartika? An upasankhyana always refers to some special context. A vartika gives you a more generalized context. Literally, the word upasankhyana means enumeration. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the difference between. For the rest of it, in this book, go in this book, I have given, because Kashika Vritti doesn't use Vaktabhyam, etc. Kashika always uses Upasankhyana. So, while translating the Kashika Vritti, okay, Kundalaya Hiranyam Randhanaya Sthali Ohanna Yukhalam Kripi Sampadu Mane Chaturthi Vaktabhyam Utraya Kalpate Javagur, etc. And then hita yoga chaturthi vaktavyaha govyo hitam is like intended for that. So govyo hitam, when the word hita is used, then what was intended for that becomes what is beneficial for that. In other words, whenever you want to express this is beneficial for that, nutritional for that, you can use chaturthi. Gobhyo hitam arochakine hitam. And then he comes back to that again. Chaturthi vidhane tadarthe upasankhyanam. Particular statement should be made when a chaturthi is used for tadarthya. So in other words, it's not a generalized rule. Instead, use, say, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these are the instances where you use this chaturthiya. See, upasankhyanam is used. So this is the upasankhyana vartika, which relates to enumeration, relates to particular situations. It's not like a generalized statement made for the vartika or by the vartika. These are all vartikas, you can go and read. Tyartho padasya karmani sthaninaha. Anyone interested in the upapada? Pravishapindim, Shastriji. Pravishapindim, pravishatarpanam, bhakshiratra sthaninatu kriyartho upapada. Tumartha accha bhava vachana, tumuna samanartha tumartha. See? Tumartha is tumuna samanartha. So what is similar to the meaning of, or what is equal to the meaning of tumun? What is the meaning of tumun? Tumartha bhava vachana pratyayanta. That is bhava vachana pratyayanta. That is why a tumartha is generally considered as for the sake of, for the purpose of, etc. Iti vakshati tasya grahanam pakaya brajati. See, paka is accomplished action. Tyagaya brajati, bhutaya brajati, sampattaya brajati, tumarthaditi kim pakas tyagaha ragaha. In other words, this is an option to tumarthacho bhava vachana.
So, that sutra, previous one, samanarthaka is used. Why is it not tulyarthaka, the way it is explained? What
I heard of the explanation is tulyartha, dvatra. Samanartha is equal. I will not say tulyartha, I will simply say samanartha. Do you have any objection?
The explanation that followed there was.
No, it's not. So Kashika uses samanartha. Okay, supposing I was using, why should I use samana? I will use tulyartha. They are the same thing.
Tumartha cha bhava vachanartha.
Yes.
So why samana additional? Tumartha cha bhava vachanartha.
Yeah.
So why tumartha samana? That word samana additional.
The word tumartha is explained as that whose meaning is similar to that of affix tumun. In other words, it is the meaning of affix tumun. A chaturthi is introduced after a nominal stem which ends in an affix used with the signification of root sense bhava. It is a bhava which is similar to the meaning of tum.
I need to understand. I think that other people will comprehend that.
No. If you are talking about the choice of the word tulya as against samana, then you shouldn't worry about that. I don't find any difference in that.
Tumunaha samana.
It's the same thing. Tumunartha. So if you are saying that it has to be similar to the meaning of tumun, then you can use tulya, you can use samana, whatever you want to use. Pakaya brajati, tyagaya brajati, tyaktum brajati. Yeah, the same thing. Bhutaya brajati. Shastriji, you're tough. Bhava vachanatikaraka. Vasvasti swaha swadha. Alang Vashad Yogacha. This is really very complex. Namaswasti Swaha Alang Vashad is Ete Yoga Chaturthi Vaktabhya. Is there any Vartika on this one? Shakto Mallo Mallaya Vashad Agnaya Vashad Indraya Chakara Punarasya Iva Samuchayartha Tena Ashir Vivakshayam Api Sashthim Badhitva Chaturthi Va Bhavati Manya Karmaniya Nadare. Yeah, Ashmanam Dishadam Manye, Manye Kashtam Ulukhalam. I don't even consider you a piece of stone. And you can even go to Natva Swanam Manye, Natva Sune Manye, Yushmada Kasmadna Bhavati, Chaturthi Etadapihi Manyate Karma, Vyavasthit Vibhasha Vijnana Deva Na Bhavati. What is Vyavasthit Vibhasha? Vibhasha is option. Vyavasthit Vibhasha is what? Vibhasha only over there and not anywhere else. A particular context where an option is made. That is what Vivasthit Vibhasha is. These are instances where you can insult people by using this kind of Sanskrit. Although Sanskrit is a language which doesn't use this kind of expressions for insulting anybody. Sanskrit becomes very violent in insulting people only in compounds. Either you make a compound or you don't make a compound. If you make a compound, it might become insulting. If you do not make a compound, it might not become. So that's what. By the way, anadara is not too much insult. It's neutral insult. And this is no problem. Saharthena yukte pradhane tritiya vibhakti bhavati. Pitra saha agataha. Yena anga vikaraha. So, yena, a limb which is responsible for making someone, yes. So that is why the word anga is used here in the sense of part located within the body, its whole. What is referred to by yena, that by means of which is a body part serving as cause of its deformity. That's why if a person has but only one eye, you describe him as akshana kana. And there you use the tritiya after the limb which has caused this deformity. Itham bhuta lakshane. Kanchit prakaram praptam itham bhutaha. Tasya lakshanam itham bhuta lakshanam. Tadastitiya vivastir bhavati. Api bhavan kamandaluna chhatramadrakshit. So you are looking for a student who was carrying a kamandalu, and that way the kamandalu becomes the characteristic mark or identification by that student. Itham bhuta lakshana, state thus reached a characteristic mark. Hetau. What is hetu? Phala sadhana yogya padartho loke hetu ichyate. See, this is a different meaning of hetu. Hetu is not a reason. Hetu is not, but this one is phala sadhana yogya padartho loke, a thing which facilitates results. A thing which is capable of serving as a means of bringing about results is popularly called hetu. So it's like asking some question, kena hetuna vasati atra varanasyam. Why are you staying here? For what purpose? To accomplish what?
And why did he pick up that Kriyaya Shokam? Grammatically, I understand, but why Kriyaya Shokam?
Well, some people think that, you know, a daughter is born, that is the problem, the trouble. Yeah, right. So, unless hetur vasati. So, kena hetuna vasati atra varanasyam, unless hetu. Sarunam nastiti acha apadane panchami, apadane karke panchami vakte bhavati, gramada gachati, etc., etc. You know, apadana is used when apaya is indicated. So, dhruvam apaya apadanam, and apaya is movement away, but dhruvam apaya apadanam, that when you have to express apaya, movement away, then you use the chaturthi. So, I think we mentioned about Bhartrihari brings this thing. So, you don't get the sense of sthiratva. The horse is running, and he's falling off the horse, the running horse. So, where is this sthiratva? dhruvatva. So it has to be a relative statement right at the time when he fell, he was dhruva. That's the time. Enapadvitiya, prithakvina nana bhistitiya, anyatarasyam. This anyatarasyam, about prithakvina nana, etc. These are particular conditions under which, this is why we say, this anyatarasyam titiya is dictated by the use of the word prithak nana, etc. Vina vatam vina varsham vidyut prapatanam vina vina hasti kritan doshan keno kene mau patitau drumam. Vina vatam vina varsham vidyut prapatanam vina. The wind did not hit. The rain did not hit, lightning didn't hit, and no elephant went wild. Then how these two trees were felled? This is the use of vina. That is nana vina. So vina conditions that dvitiya. Sattam yadikarne cha charmani dvipinam hanti dantayor hanti kunjaram keshe sujamarim hantim simni pushkalako. The ridreshu asinesu ritta punjante vrishalesu asinesu brahmanas taranti. Akarakarhanam chakarakatve saptami vaktabhya riddhesu bhunjanesu daritraj asate brahmanesu taratsu vishala asate yascha bhavena bhava lakshanam. This is interesting. Yascha bhavena bhava lakshanam. No, the saptami is carried over. The word bhava means kriya here. Yeah. The phrase yasya cha bhavena means an action which marks another action. The phrase yasya cha bhavena means an action which may marks another action. A saptami is introduced after a nominal stem by whose action another action is marked. A commonly known action is generally used to mark another action. Why do we state the condition of bhavena by action? Consider, yo jatabhis sa bhungte. This is namo bhava. Bhava is not marking. Action root sense used again. Consider, yo bhungte sa devadatta, he who is eating is devadatta, he who eats is devadatta, where action of eating marks devadatta in non-action. Sashti chanadare, oh yeah, rudata prabrajit, rudati prabhra. He became an ascetic, leaving the relatives crying. Swamishwarana. Sashti is a very notorious vibhakti. Yeah. You can have all kinds of things expressed with Sashti. Nakshatre Chaduti. Aha. Pratipatikarthaling Parimana Vachan Vartre Prathama. They don't want us to go any further. So, anyway, this is something very tough. Pratipatikartha. So, what is the sense of Pratipatika? And there are debates whether Linga and Vachana should be included in the meaning of the Pratipadika. Pratipadika artha satta. Satta is what? To be? Yeah. See, the thing is, that is what we were earlier on talking. See, Pratishedha, you were talking about Pratishedha. Satta is one which cannot be negated. If you negate Satta, then there is no way you can establish Satta. So, for example, you say, Ishwarah nasti. Right? That doesn't make any sense. You first have to believe that Ishwara is. Unless you accept that Ishwara is, you cannot negate it. What is the useless exercise? That's why they say, I have written it so many times at so many places with so many things corroborating it, that if a negative provision does not make any sense unless a positive provision is already made. So, unless you accept that Ishwara is... Yeah. Of course has to be prasajya. And the Pratipadik Matra, etc. See, in this one, Pratipadikartha, all these indeclinables and others, you have to establish their Pratipadikarthatva so that you can introduce the Su. So that you can form a compound. So that you can take care of the integrative processes. One to 45 is the rule that defines Pratipadika. Nipatasya anarthakasya pratipadikatvam uktam tvatopi yathasyat. See?
That is covered.
No, wherever you have this doubt that this word form is not carrying any meaning, even there you have to imagine meaning. If you don't imagine the meaning, you can't talk about Pratipadikartha.
That point.
What?
Please explain that.
Yeah, ditta kapittaha. Think of a word which doesn't have any meaning. Yeah. Simply because you said it, this is a Pratipadika. Otherwise, how would you derive ditta? Ditta, you cannot derive ditta unless you introduce su. And you cannot introduce su unless you have a Pratipadika. And Pratipadika can be defined only based on it, if it carries some kind of meaning, Pratipadikartha. And this is the satta of the Pratipadikartha that a Vayakarana accepts. See, that's why it says tatopi yathasyat. Yeah, nipatasya narthakasya pratipadikatva muktam.
And when you use the word satta, the pratipadikartha satta, is it anything, this wild imagination, is it anything to do with dhuvadhu dhatu and then dhu satta?
No, this is not talking about dhatu.
The meaning of the word dhatu satta, dhu is related to.
Yeah, it doesn't have to do anything with Pratipadika. It has to do with dhatu.